Hello everyone. Today I am going to introduce and explain to you how to use an extension that is simply awesome. This is Universal Importer, developed for free by Samuel Talat. It allows you to import 60 different types of 3D files with or without texture. Here is the list of file types supported by its extension. You can see some sample models that I have imported. It works really well. The quality depends on the software that made it possible to model the different models here. It goes from a very simple shape like the tree, to a superb quality like the stones, or the dandelion hair. We can see the work on the leaves as well as the flower. The cheetah isn't bad either. You can also see the quality of the leaves and flowers on the plant on the left. The same goes for the garage door and the alarm clock I put on it. And in addition, Universal Importer can reduce the number of polygons of imported models, but also on your own models. Here, for example, we go from 10,000 faces to only 1,000. The file will be much lighter to work with in SketchUp. Of course, I'm going to tell you how to import the files, how to reduce the number of polygon faces, but also the few problems you might encounter and how to solve them easily. First, you need to download the latest version of Universal Importer from SketchUcation. It is free, but you need to create an account to download it. I include for you the link in the description. You should know that Samuel has spent hundreds of hours developing this extension over several years and he continues to develop it. You have a link to support his work with a small donation. Thank you for it. Otherwise, just click on download. Now just install the extension and check the toolbar if it is not displayed, like here on the screen. If you have any problems using the extension or if you need improvements, you can contact Samuel directly in French on my Discord server. There is a channel dedicated to Universal Importer, or in English on SketchUcation. I put the two links in the description. As I told you before, Universal Importer imports 60 different file types with or without textures. Most of them work very well. There is almost 100% success with GLB, STL, FBX, but recent on the other hand, OBJ, STEP, IGAS, Collada, so the DAE, the GLTF. There are some problems with transparencies such as foliage or windows, but he is working on improving them. Unfortunately for Mac owners, there are some problems, but he is working on that as well. So keep an eye out for updates in the next versions. Blend files above Blender version to AN3MF files don't really work. He is working on it, but it mainly depends on the development of Blender and a simp. Textures names are preserved almost 100%. In the future, it will propose to keep the hierarchy of groups and components of the original models. For now, this overwrites everything and creates a global component. Come on, let's see how to use the Universal Importer and then how to solve the little problems we encountered. All models were downloaded for free from Trader and Polyhaven. If you have links to other sites offering free models, feel free to add them in the comments or add them to Discord. Thank you very much. There are two possible techniques for downloading, depending on the site. Here is the first technique. We start with Polyhaven. It's very simple. Click on the image. On this chair, for example. Then we choose the quality. I'm going to stick on 1K. The file will be smaller. Then we choose extension, either GLTF or FBX. I stay on GLTF. And we click on download. Once the file is downloaded, you have to unzip it. Right click. Extract everything. I delete the compressed file. And I rename this one, chair. Please note that it is necessary to have a different folder for each model downloaded. This is because it is different files and folders. In addition, the Universal Importer is going to create new files when importing into SketchUp. This keeps the files for each model in the right place without mixing them up. We are now ready to import our chair. To do this, I go to Extensions, Universal Importer. I don't check anything. I go straight to import a 3D model. I select my file and click open. It asks me for the units of the source model. We don't touch them. I press OK. This takes a few seconds. Do I want to reduce the number of polygons? For now I say no, we will see why later. This will take a few seconds. My chair has appeared. It is indeed a component. You can see it in the list. We can see that there are visible edges. All that remains is to soften them. I select my component. I select and I can change the number of degrees. We can clearly see all the textures on my component. For the second technique, let's go to Creator. Once you have selected the model, you need to download the correct files, because the author of the model did not compress them in zip format. You have to download the textures first. So I click on download here. You can either download the file in FBX or OBJ. So I'm going to download the two types to show you the first problem we may encounter. For the two file types, we have the choice between two qualities, either low quality, or QUAD, high quality. First, I click on the FBX file, download. Then I download the OBJ file. First, I import the FBX file. I have created here a folder for each item. I go to the Cheetah file. I find my OBJ, FBX file and here my textures. I import the FBX. The file was imported correctly. It is selected. I take the opportunity to smooth it immediately. I do the same now with the OBJ. We can see that the textures have not been imported. So I'll show you how to fix this. First of all, I'm going to delete my imported model. In extensions here I have to check, claim missing textures. And I start the operation again. The OBJ asks me for the default material, so I open the textures folder. The default color is my QUAD Cheetah. Open. We wait a bit. It asks us for the texture for the Cheetah. It's this one, Cheetah Quad, open. We wait a little longer. No. And here we have solved the problem. This time the textures are well applied. Just uncheck, check. We can clearly see that we have exactly the same to finish, there are no differences between the two models. The second problem you may encounter when importing a model. These are the transparencies that are sometimes not taken into account. I show you one example with the alarm clock. Don't forget to uncheck claim missing textures, otherwise it's going to ask for them every time. Here is the imported clock. I'm going to start by smoothing it out. And we notice that we don't see the hands. I open my component, I go to the materials, in my model. Here I select the materials. Editing. There I'm going to modify the transparency to reduce it. The problem is solved. I now explain you why it is better to reduce the number of face polygons after the export rather than during the export. Quite simply, if we have too few polygons, the object will be distorted or there will be missing parts. Example with the alarm clock. First of all, do not select it. I click on the icon here. It tells me that for now I have 4,279 faces. I say okay. I want 1,000 of them. I confirm. It's going to take a few seconds again. And here's what it can do with 1805 faces. We can see that there are still some problems with the shapes. Then you see that the face here has been completely altered. Just open the component. Pass here, make the surface transparent. Apply it to the texture. The results are not necessarily fantastic. Be careful, when we make reductions of faces, of polygons, it's better to do it afterwards. This made a copy, so I can just delete it and start again to find the right value. We have just seen, with the example of the alarm clock, that when we want to reduce the number of polygons, we cannot select a precise model. This means that I have 8 elements on my drawing here. If I ask for polygon reduction, it's going to reduce the number of polygons on the whole drawing, and the result will be disastrous. You can see the result for yourself. So you understand, it is better to do it file by file, and then import them directly into our final scene. The tutorial is complete, so remember to support the channel with a like, a nice comment, by clicking on the ads, by subscribing. And most importantly, join us on Discord. Thanks and see you soon for the next tutorial.